Detectives are investigating a property row involving Prophet David Owuor's repentance and holiness ministry. A family is blaming the prophet and his followers of coercing one of their members into giving away her multi-million property to the church. Makori Ongechi has more.
These high-end apartments at Mudangari Drive in Lavington Estate, Nairobi, are just but a fraction of a multi-million estate said to be owned by Jane Masharia, a former advocate of the High Court who abandoned her career 14 years ago to join Prophet Owuor's Repentance and Holiness Ministries. Jane, convicted by the message from the prophet, chose the narrow path of becoming a bishop full-time. Her family members say they never anticipated that their sister was to be lured into giving away all her property to the church.
Came to rescue my sister from the clutches of the Repentance and Holiness Church, who have, for the last 10-15 years, emasculated her property, emasculated her finances, detained her, held her under duress, and made her suffer.
Whereas she was a vibrant member of the law society who viciously defended and represented her clients in court, Jane, a mother of a 23-year-old son, is now said to have lost her memory. Her brother Duncan Njagi gives a shocking revelation of a sister who could not attend her parents' burial, never picked any phone calls or associated with family members.
My mother was sick, like I tell you, in ICU. He said to have spoken some words that brought Mama Rosa back to life. He didn't even visit. Wouldn't even allow my sister to visit with her mother. Can you imagine? Even the funeral, even the arrangements, even the condolences, they wouldn't send or allow my sister to be involved.
These people don't mean any good for my sister. Hmm. Because if they take the directorship, what else? What else? What else? They will control the finances. Do they need her? They'll control the buildings. Do they need her? They will control the cars. Do they need her? They'll finish her.
Jane Skin alleged that Prophet Owuor and his followers have taken over the property and in some instances coercing Jane to sign checks and give out her logbooks and title deeds to the church. But amidst the tussle, Kimani Wanjenga, one of the advocates representing Prophet Owuor's church, says Jane willingly offered part of her property to be used by the church in drawing more souls to their ministry as a testimony.
When Mudhoni requested that her son be prayed for, and indeed he was prayed for and got healed, then as a Christian, she offered her house for Bible study. I believe you are also Christians and you would not mind to have a Bible study in your homes.
By Monday evening, detectives had arrived at the estate to conduct investigations. Prophet Owuor is not new to controversy. In 2017, he claimed to resurrect Mama Rosa after intercessory prayers. Rosa later passed on. The self-proclaimed mighty prophet of the Lord has on several occasions displayed a flashy lifestyle, with many questioning the source of his wealth. Makori Ongechi, Citizen TV, Nairobi.